Hello everyone, welcome to today's stream, where we're mostly just going to be farming more silver at Kuori, I'm not sure how to say it, but that's where we are. We need a new reel if we can, so that's what we're looking for. So we'll get started, I guess. I've actually had the game up for a while, but trying to help a mate with the stream, so. And it's just getting dark. Great timing. Oh well. It is what it is. Let's do the 3 hour one for now. Let's get going. See if we can get anything at all. Let's have a couple of teas while we're moving out. Get some energy back. Now, I'm not going to be surprised if we suddenly get a big one too around now. Quite a few of my bigger fish here have often been just before it really gets dark. Ooh, we're not quite on track as much as ideal. Let's see. Yeah, it's probably getting better. Oh, we've got a fish on. But it is not as big as we might hope. But it, no, it's an Arctic char. What does they mean by? Hopefully my mic's not too sensitive now that you can hear too much computer noise. I'm trying to do a bit more fiddling with it, and it seems to be staying on a bit longer than ideal. I know it's dark. Ideally, we'd stop and maybe go for Burbot, but let me know, guys, if my mic is picking up too much or still missing bits. I was listening to previous videos and I noticed some words, or at least early syllables in words, seem to get missed if I talk too quiet, so tried to do some modifications. Getting a proper mic is on my books, but not yet. The headset's fine for now. Nothing at night, and my music I cannot hear. Let's turn my music up a step or two. I've gone too far. As long as we don't catch too many pike, we're good. Oh, we're going too close to the island. Nearly crashed into it. I'm all at sea tonight. Or all at lake, maybe? Let's have a carrot. It is, of course, a bit slow. But it is dark. Previous times when I've actually gone, though, I've actually caught quite a few. Oh, there we go. We got something. I think... is that a pike? It is. Evil... things. When you've got a fluorocarbon leader, at least. The little ones are alright, but they're not really worth anything. Come on, son. Get up so I can catch some bigger fish. Got a whole two fish so far. And none of them have been even... remotely decent. I was playing about, what was it, 2 hours ago? I had about half an hour to kill. And did get a just under trophy lake trout. It was only a few grams under, apparently. Or maybe 500 grams or something. Which is a shame that I didn't get it. But oh well. It is what it is. We can't choose what fish we get on the line. But that would probably be my new second biggest fish. Oh. But before, when I was fishing, I seem to be just getting lake trout for some reason. Very strange it was. I always go too far. Ah well. As long as we don't get a pike, I'm more than happy still. Which I don't seem to actually get the pike quite here. The big pike that I've got is just around the when we start turning to the left. Lost one lure that way. Here we go. He's not a big one. And he is not a pike, I think. No. It's a lake trout. Which seems to be what we're getting at the moment. I'm not sure why. Where are we? Bit shallow. Apparently the weekly records have still been with the orange hunter mostly, so I don't know. That's what I'm using, a hunter 2 on this one and a hunter 3 on that one, I think. I think that's the right way around. Or is it the other one? No, that's the 2 and that's the 3. I've found in general the 2 seems to get more than the 3 does for some reason. I guess it's a smaller bait. Catches more fish, but it also gets bigger fish. If my music's too loud, please tell me as well, guys. It is set that mostly to drown out the monotony of the motor, but I find it still useful to have the motor because of when that happens. That the motor suddenly, the sound drops out when you've got a fish on. What is this, do we think? He's fighting good. Maybe it's still another trout, I think. That'd be my guess. It's either a trout or I don't think it's a pike, because pikes seem to just run straight away from you when the char and the trout seem to dive deep, I think. Ooh, he's a Kuori char. Get up here. No, he's gone. Again. Come on. She was so close too. I had the net out at the right time. All my energy's gone. Come on, just one. Try lifting him up. He was only 4.5. Oh well. He's still good money. Have a couple of carrots. I like to eat them whether or not they're useful or not. Well, hopefully we can get a few more that size or bigger. How are we this day, I guess? How is everyone? Are we fishing? If we're fishing, how are we going? Good to have you here anyway. Oh, we're a fish on. Not a big one though. Don't you go diving? I should. Drop that down a little bit. Just so that we, if a real monster comes along, we don't just get bitten off or broken off straight away. Not that that's actually ever happened for me, but I assume that would happen if you got a record curry char that comes along and just goes boom. I'd imagine something's gonna break if you got your tension too high. think now is where to turn. Something along that line, I think. Yeah. I'm finally starting to learn where the path of the deeper water is. Just doing that loop. Because you got more deep water there. You could, of course, do one across there as well, but... Oops, we're... Not big fish on. Didn't really need to stop, but... He'll come in quicker. Half a kilo. So, in other words, a waste of my time. We need fish that are lots more. Lots bigger. Worth more. Oop. Interesting. Today the 3 is getting more fish. Still a too small one. At least we're getting fish. And not just doing laps for no reason. I've had that happen, even with hunters on. But before I had hunters, I'd often do lap and lap and lap and nothing. The occasional perch, the very occasional pike. Some of that I now know is my leader was a steel one, because I see pike there, they use steel. I now know. Ideally, you have to try and risk getting a bitten off to get the other ones. Not to say that I didn't ever actually get the occasional char on a steel leader. More when I was doing land base retrieval. Ooh. This could be another curry char. I've never caught a char though. That's something I'd like to do. But char don't seem to go for the same spoons and stuff. Thought I heard my that happening. My drag gone. Up you come. Well, at least he's a tagged fish. Not a big one, but... A tagged curry char's got to be worth at least a few silver. But when I was fishing earlier, I caught a 300 gram curry char. I did not know that they came that small. Of course there should be baby ones, but I mean catchable ones. Right on track. Perfect. If you're wondering why I don't use a third rod, that's two reasons. One, I don't have a third rod. Yet. Not that that's up to catching decent sized fish anyway. Ooh, it's a hide. Seem to get them occasionally, but we don't ever get big ones. Occasionally the cafe has orders for like 10 kilo ones or something, I think. Here. That's 10 kilo. Which, that would be a solid fight, I think. Based on how much they fight when you're, catching them on, feeder rods. Another little something. These big lures catch a lot of small fish. Hey! Welcome, Bell Sherman. How are you going today? I am not too bad. A bit rainy outside, but it's night time anyway, so it doesn't really matter, and we really haven't had lots of rain this year, or even last year. It's been pretty dry, so every bit is good. You must sleep some odd times, I think. Or did you just have a nap, maybe? If you have a nap sometimes you really feel worse than when you went down, I think. At least for a while. Well, hopefully you feel better anyway. Soon. That's still very normal. I hear. That, it's only since the Industrial Revolution that we're expected to sleep the whole night. That apparently 200 years ago or before, it was very common for people to wake up around midnight, get up, eat some food, stay up for like an hour, and then go back to sleep for another 4 hours or so. Just because we're went to be working in factories and stuff, that our time schedules and whatever are all messed up. That's what I heard on the television anyway. On Adam Ruins Everything. Which he normally does present scientific paper citations, so if he's got proper citations, who am I to argue? How's your little guy going? Your smaller leveled person. Your account. Have you passed me yet? Nearly. You're catching up quick, but then again, it is easier to catch up. The first few levels are pretty quick, especially if you know what you're doing. When I think I've been still pretty quick, but to get to 20, what on 192 days? I think that's not too bad. That's under 10 days a level. And I only play this now every 3 to 4 times a week. At most. Before I went for my dinner, I wasn't streaming this, but I think it should be still there. I got this lake trout earlier today. I think that's 300 grams short of a trophy. Which, it's sad that it's 300 grams short of a trophy, because trophies are nice to catch, but. And it actually wasn't too hard to get. It took about 5 minutes to reel in. But 5 minutes is not bad. Not like my big curry char. And my big curry char, I see, is tiny. The weekly record holder's got a 23 kilo curry char. Ah, very nice. I'd imagine a 23 kilo Kurijar or Yomura would fight pretty hard. Is my mic and music sounding alright? Sure. A big-ish something? Well. At least 2 kilo fish. No, it was only 1.7. Because it was a pike. Stupid pike. This seems to be where I get the pike too. Over the deeper, or just coming into this really deep water here. Which unfortunately will, if they're big enough, bite you off. Luckily he was not big enough. Turn a bit sharper. Try and stay closer to that deep water. Not that deep water seems to guarantee big fish, but and another little pike. One thing I am wondering a little bit. Does the depth that your spoon sits in the water affect what you catch? Or how far out your lure is? I might turn the music down just one. One stop, so it's just a little quieter. So it's more background, at least from my perspective anyway. Tell me another. No, it's an Arctic, I think, or is that a 7? No, it's a lake. Didn't get many seven. Seven, or however you say it. I think just after the market. Hands are busy. And a little pitch. Well, we're definitely going to be making some money, but we're not super, super hot yet. I think that's our biggest weight. At 4.3, 4.4, I mean. Still. At least we caught a Kuori Char. Don't get many of them. Ooh. Another one on. Trying. Two and a half. Do you guys know what the ultimate clip is for fishing for or trawling, assuming that there is such a thing? Oh, we got one on. And he's a little dude. Another lake trout. And not even a decent sized one, really. Not like my 9.5 kilo one. That I caught before I started streaming today. And even he didn't fire that hard. But just that short for a trophy. Ah well. Still my second biggest fish so far. They're not bent over enough. It's always odd, I find, when you go over the deep hole here, that you actually often don't catch fish, and if you do, they're not necessarily big ones. Ooh, we finally got something on. But he's nothing to get too excited about. It probably is actually a good size Vindace, I guess. It's amazing that such a small fish will take a big lure. I wish I'd catch a decent perch though. If I'm gonna catch a perch, I want it to be at least tagged, and ideally a kilo or more plus. Something that's actually worth keeping. But I think here, I don't know if I've ever caught a tagged perch here, or at least on a lure. I seem to only get tiny little dudes. Oh, we're on, but not big. I'm not going to get money if I keep catching these little fish. Unless the market's after them, that is. I mean the cafe. Which I guess is still a market, but... What are we fishing for today, chat? Assuming you're fishing and watching? I'd love to know. You got any questions or tips? Suggestions? Anything? Yep, you gotta do that. Had your partner gone shopping? Or was it delivered? I guess if it's delivered you should need to unload, but... Can you get toilet paper? This is a really odd question, but can you? My supermarket still can't keep toilet paper in stock. I have some toilet paper, but I haven't been able to buy any since I haven't bought any since February. Luckily, in February, I got like one of these big packs that last a month or more, but I've got some off my parents who've been able to get some, but I haven't seen a single pack since early March. Yeah, I got like a 16 pack or something back in February. And it's only two people in my house. Both so it's me and my brother that we live together. He works from home now with me. He's a programmer. Doing in-house software. And me, I fill my time with Twitch at the moment and YouTube. Not much photography happening when you can't go and take photos, can't get close enough to take photos of people, and they can't be in a crowd. That's what I do, I'm a photographer. Come on, fish. Do I need to put my friction up once more? Is that a pike? That's probably starting to get to the size where you need to worry about him biting you off. I imagine. Why are we facing that direction? Yeah, well, I'm still using the leader you sent me, which is the 13 kilo fluorocarbon. I lost one of them to a pike, but you sent me three, and so I've still got enough for two rods. Another little something. Where's some of the big fish? I'm not saying huge fish, just big. And it's another pike. Where's the Arctic char? Should be fine to 5 kilos. Which means the one that I lost must have been over 5 kilos then. Because I hooked him sort of just as I normally turn, and he went down that way. I don't think the tension ever got to the red. It might have stayed in the orange, but if you don't get tension at least in the orange, then you're never gonna, you're just gonna get spooled. I think that's the case. You need some break to wear them out to, I think. Round we go. Round the cursed island. With the giant dead tree in it. This is quite an amazing water body to have such big fish. Considering it's not that big. Have a carrot too. What? It's infested with pike, you mean? Or fish in general? There's plenty of fish here. And we just keep catching more of them. These digital fish. They must be amazing breeders and amazing growers. Of course, a day is only an hour of real time, so a year is only 365 hours, which would only be, that'd be less than a month, wouldn't it? It'd be, I'm trying to think, 7 times 24. Times 60. I don't remember how many hours there are in a week. But I think it's over 200, isn't it? Can see my lure now. Got just dark enough to get rid of the glare. $168. So a bit over a fortnight is a year. That's still going to be fished out quicker than I'd imagine fish could recover. If this was like a simulation of real time. Given how many fish people catch. Oh, we do get something. You seem, well, I've in the recent past, there are no fish in there. There are sometimes, they just caught one, but it wasn't a big one. But I have seemed to catch a lot of. True, they do spawn. Well, they don't actually spawn as. They don't spawn on your line. They do actually spawn from about 10 meters away, I think. And then I'll swim towards your line and. Often. Get on it. But not always. At least if it's a feeder rod. Because if you're fishing over here on the shallows with good light and stuff, like your torch and whatever, you can see the fish coming to take your bait. You can actually also, if you're really, really watching your trawling, and you've got the lure not set too far away, you can often just see the fish go. This is happy hour. Come on, fishy. What's our bet? I think that looks maybe troutish. It is troutish. Nice. What is a good size for a 7 trout? Seven. They can get to 17 kilograms. That would be a big one. What's the weekly? Yes. People have got 12s this week. Thank you though. It's at least a tagged one. They must be quite a rare species here, the Severn trout. They seem nearly, probably slightly rarer than the Kuori or Kuori or however you say this lake's name, jar. Yeah, I hope so. That's what we're here for. Trying to get that naga. Do you reckon the naga's the best option to get? For the lure? For the reel, I mean. Unfortunately, lake trout are mostly junk fish. Alphas. I'll have to have a look and see what an alpha is. But you suggested I should get nagas. Didn't you? I think you were saying I should get nagas the last time we were chatting. But is a naga better than the gold ones? I think that's, they're about the same price. I'm not sure I know what the difference is between them. Well, if you promote them, then they must be good. I'm sure if they're in the game, they're all going to have goodness to them, I'm sure. People would just... they'd have to remove stuff if it was not up to scratch, I'd imagine. Once you start getting to paying multiple thousands of silver, how often do you repair your stuff? Because I've never had to do that yet. Turn the music down another notch. Repair once a week. Wow. That's a lot, especially considering it takes like a day or something to repair one, doesn't it? I wouldn't know what 4450 was. Other than... oh, 2.5 hours is not bad. You could easily get one going when you go to bed and... I understand it's a spot on the map, I'm just... Bear is not a place that I frequent. I was there once when I unlocked it. I went and had a look. I saw there was no shop. And I saw the size of the fish and gone, I'm not ready for this. Nice. 37 kilo, very nice. Happy hour did not continue throughout the night. Shame. What do people catch Savan on anyway? Just the spoons? I can imagine. 37 sounds very nice. I certainly can't imagine catching something quite that big yet. Now let's go back and find out what the weekly. So then. So, hunters. Deep run and minnow seem to be. Took 2.5 hours. No thanks. That's some dedication. To just keep something for that long. But I guess, do sturgeon go on particularly big runs? I think they're just more lumps, aren't they? Like really powerful lumps. That you're really fighting the Yeah. I can imagine that they're more just really, really big and heavy, and so they. It just takes a lot of effort to actually bring them in. Do you think? Should I be making coffee now, do you think? That's one thing I was just thinking of. Because I was watching, yesterday. Was it yesterday? Yeah, last night. In Red Rock Panda's stream, he was drinking lots of coffee. Because I have not made a single pot of coffee yet. Only got all my tea here. And coffee boosts your energy quicker than tea does. Coffee is only for when you have a big fish on. I'll have to keep that in mind. We might even consider stopping and making some after we've done this one. Yeah, well, you would have seen I've been drained a few times, and I try and have some, drink some tea, and it does help a bit, but. Not lots. Yeah, I realized I need a coffee pot. Ooh. Coffee is quite expensive. Yeah. Well, good coffee should be not cheap. I imagine this is still not good coffee though. Don't buy here. Yeah, probably true. Everything's expensive here. But then again, if I go somewhere else, it costs 25 silver to come back here anyway, so if the difference is less than 25 silver, it's still probably actually worth it to buy it here. Because 25 silver is not nothing. Is this the only place you can get cheese? I think this might be the only place to get cheese. Oops. Not that I need any cheese at the moment, because I have bought some and cut it up to make bait. So I should be brim fishing now, apparently. Who was saying? Somebody that I've had a chat to suggested that brim like when it's raining. At least that was when I was at Volkov. Depends on a lot of things. True. If the fish aren't there, the fish aren't there. The fish do move. Well, that's what everybody keeps saying anyway, they do. And I guess I have encountered that a bit. Yeah, for sure. Because there's a... For example, when I have done brim fishing 24 hours a day, at Winding Rivulet especially, and even at Oldberg as well. I've tended to get sub 1 kilo after about 10 a.m. and then anywhere between 10 p.m. and 10 a.m. you can get the big ones. The big ones often were biting from close to the 10 a.m. mark, like 9 or 8 or something. Hopefully this is at least 200-300 silver. But I think I'll need to do something else tomorrow. I tend to get bored a little bit fishing the same water body too often. Need some variety. Oh, there's something on. Oh, what you sending me? We'll have a look after this one lands. Nope. It's not a huge whatever he is, but... Eh, 3.5's not too bad. But he's only worth maybe 10 silver. At most. What's this one worth? Do you have any use for perch, small perch? Can I send them? Maybe I can't. Never mind, I guess. Where are we? Messages. Oh, wow. Thank you very much. Earl Sherman, you are very kind. We'll go for a longer trawl this time. May as well go fishing, trawling past the campsite so we can make some. And hopefully we don't need it. Do I need to have a special something to send you to send bait to people? I think you had to be level 20 to be able to send anything at all. But I see people are often sending bait to people. You have to be premium. Yeah, I guess that probably was the case. I'd happily give you my little perch that I've caught if they were any use. I may well consider getting premium at least once, but not till next month. No income this month, but the government will be giving me money next month. And I imagine Crispy does too. Yeah. I'm sure I can give them to Banda. we're going this way. You can't send ordinary fish to people. What do you mean by that? Aren't little perch fairly common? Oh, you have to make them into bait fish first. Well, I cannot do that yet. That's something I need to work on. Bait making a bit more, my ground bait, definitely. On my Discord? You shouldn't have, not that there's much to see yet, but why do we make a fire? Need to craft coffee. A 3, a 4. A 7, that's not bad. An 8's even better. And a 4. May as well make 4 more since we're here. I wasn't sure how many was in a tin. 7, good. Five, okay. And we failed at making coffee. Yeah, it's 10 per tin. And that's the 10th one. L. I wasn't sure. Yeah, I think you said that. Which is kind of, how can you fail it? At making hot water and putting flavoring in it. Maybe put some sugar and some milk too, depending on how you like it. Shaky hands. Do you have shaky hands? You don't have to say. But yes, I guess that is one reason why I guess you could fail. The last being your daughter or your wife? Partner. Yeah, unfortunately, two of my uncles they got different forms of Parkinson, unfortunately. One of them's a shaky one, and the other one's the opposite. I do have a fish on there. Well, I'm very sorry to hear. That she's got that too. Whatever is causing it. Certainly not nice to not have full control over your motor skills. Am I still alive, by the way? Just old age, oh, okay. If you don't mind me asking, how old are you, or even just ballpark? Are you over 60, for example? 54. I'm 38. Aha. Do you have any kids? So do you have any sons? Or... because you obviously... you said you didn't have any daughters, so... you have three sons. Very good. Do any of them still live with you? I think this is a pike. This is either a pike or just a big something else. What do you reckon? Pike? Maybe? Maybe a really big lake trout? Because lake trout do this a little bit. Maybe even a big eyed could be. Not good at curry fish. Fair enough. He seems to have mostly worn himself out already, so maybe it's a curry char? Curry? Did you know that you spelt it wrong as well? I've often spelt it curry. K-O-U-R-I, but it's actually K-U-O-R-I. It's a very odd spelling, but it's Russian, I guess, so... I always thought it was spelled that way too, so I'm not having a go at you in any way, I'm just... I realized that yesterday. That it was like, oh, it's the U is before the O. That is very strange. Yeah, when we were chatting about it, I realized, oh, it's UO, not OU. I think it's the game people made it spelt the wrong way. We're the ones who got it right. They just don't know how to spell. I'm guessing this is the time to have some... some coffee. Two coffees and two teas. Could be going to the toilet all night if you have two coffees and two teas. Get no sleep and up all night peeing. starting to recover. Not the best time for a big fish. In the middle of the rain, I mean. The rain is certainly a pain when you have you lose so much comfort and so energy takes so much input to maintain normalness. Can I see color yet? I don't think so. It is... yeah. It's a curator! Really? He was only 5.6 kilos? Ah, well. That's good, but I've had bigger that seem to fight. It's still a good fish, for sure. But I've had bigger fish when I was fishing over at the campsite on land. I think that it's still... that's well over a 50 silver though fish, I think. Which 50 silver is nothing to sneeze at. That's if I'm remembering right. It might only be 30 or 40, I don't know. Something like that. Oh, we're getting a little bit close to that island. Well, silver is what we're after, so... seemed like my rod here got stuck on something for a minute. No, don't you go running off. True. Never thought of that. Good to know. A lot of other guys seem to totally ignore food. They seem to only fill up on drinks, so coffee and alcohol and tea. Yeah, I know, but lots of people, other people that I've chatted to, they say don't bother eating. I think they're just dumb or something. They're uneducated. Starting to rain, get dark. Tea's pretty cheap though. Of course, carrots are very cheap too. Oh, I got another, probably another perch. Yep. At least those two were tagged. All of the other perch have been not even that. And another one. Must be swimming, trawling through a perch. No? We lost him. Did it say fish got... Yeah, it did say fish got away. I must have been swimming... I mean, had my lure swim through a school. Good thing the rain doesn't settle in your boat. This much rain would fill up your rubber ducky. This type of boat, at least as far as our lifesavers are concerned. Call them rubber duckies. Because they're often yellow and whatever, yellow and red. Yeah, except water doesn't work that way. It tends to go the other way. And I don't think even if you had a one-way valve, it would work, because water is somewhat the same. There's not enough weight difference between water and water. A little bit more that way, I think. It does seem odd, though, that you'd have a rubber boat for a fishing game. It's not really, really rubber, though. It's more like multi-layered with canvas and whatever stuff inside. But given that you're got these big hooks and stuff, and pike with their big sharp teeth. I foul hooked that one. I reckon he was foul hooked. You really should be able to foul hook stuff in this game if you're not familiar with the term. It's when you hook a fish not in the mouth, so you get lucky and the hook just goes in the body somewhere. But But when that happens, fish often fight really hard. Yeah. I've caught a few fish gang hooked. I mean, not gang, foul hooked before. That year. It often happens when, like, you're going to set the hook and the fish is sort of swimming past or something, and the setting maybe doesn't actually get the fish that you're going for. I fish a little bit. I go fishing I used to go about 2 to 3 times a year fishing, but with the current situation, that probably is less likely to happen. That said, I watched 2 different people in Australia streaming fishing, like real life fishing, today. One guy was in Western Australia, and the other guy was in Queensland. Yeah. 12 weeks is a long time. How many weeks are you into the 12 weeks? Or has it already been 12 weeks? Got my letter yesterday. So the government... Oh, so you're not allowed to go out at all for 3 months. So that's a government thing, is it? That they're mandating that you can't go outside, I'm guessing for your protection more than other people's, because I doubt you're infected. Vulnerable people. Well, I'm very sorry for you. You get lots of time to play more fishing, I guess. Yeah. You don't have it great in the UK, unfortunately. Where I am, so I'm in South Australia, we have had 0 new cases today. We only had 1 case the last 2 days, and then another 0, so we're only getting like maybe 3 or 4 cases a week now. So they're talking about potentially eradicating the virus. That we're not just flattening the curve, we're crushing the curve to try and make it extinct in our population. And it could be only a month or so before that happens, the way that we're going, I think. Which is very good. Who knows yet? Stuff could get worse here still, I guess, but it seems unlikely. They seem to have be doing really good testing and contact tracing. Especially in my state. So is your partner also going to have to isolate, or with you? Or does she still work? Because it for essential trips. She retired. Is that a fish? I think I can see a fish on there. I can see a fish on there. Well, hopefully things improve in the UK for you, that your 12 weeks might not be 12 weeks, but I guess it's still likely to be at least 10 weeks. Because it is possible to crush it totally. 10:30 p.m. for me. Which would mean it's 2 p.m. for you. I think. Yeah. Be just 2:07 for you. Because we're 9.5 hours ahead. Panda must be feeling better. Last weekend he'd stopped by this time, I think. That's good. I'm actually amazed how many people are streaming at the moment. He's gone over? What do you mean he's gone over? He's raiding somebody else. Yeah. So he's either really trying to do something or he's feeling better. Or probably a bit both, a bit of both. Now that he's 1/2 an hour behind me, I'm more likely to stay up later than he is. He's brim fishing at Volkov. There you go. Do we have a fish on? I think I do. Not going to be catching another fish if I've already got a fish on there. I'll have to try going fishing there again. Maybe tomorrow. That's if there are actually any decent fish there. Because I haven't caught any decent bream there yet. I tend to Fimba. I have never caught one of them. But what bait do they go for? What do you catch a vimba on? What's the main bait? Oh, NC, I don't know. NC, oh, night crawlers. And beetle larva. Wasn't I using beetle larva? Yeah, I think I was using beetle larva. I'll have to give it a go though. Yeah, well, I need to level up my ground bait. My ground bait making skills is get a fish on this one first. Because my ground bait's only 9.7. Yeah. I need to make more ground bait. Oh. Oh, what you sending me? What's that one? Is that a Vimbo one? Thank you very much. Second one. Thank you very much again. Ooh, starting to get the yawns. I think I'll keep going till it gets to the next night. So, probably, what's that? Um, 14 hours, probably? So... Ooh, a savan trout. So probably just over a half hour. Do you know what the competition is? Do you play the Steam version even? You probably can't be playing the Steam version, I'm guessing. Unless you've got three different Steam accounts. You have both. Do you know what the competition is that they're just spammed in? Elwoodiath? Elwoodiath. Maybe he's a German person or something. There's a lot of German streamers, so that's why I... Let's turn the English off so I can see everyone. He streams in English. Oops. Did I close the baler? I don't think we did. Aha. So he's European, probably, or maybe American? Cool. I've caught a few wild-eyed brunette winding rivulet recently. Well, when I was last there anyway. And a couple at the Volkov as well. They're fairly ugly fish in a way. Very slimy looking. Another Savan, but a small one. It's amazing all of the different languages and countries people play this game from. It's a real melting pot, this one is. And we're all on the same server. Oh, a little baby curry. He's only 800 grams. So, probably last half hour from now, I think. Peachy. Come back here, Mr. Fishy. Wonder what this one is. Do I see colour? I don't think so. Nope, not colour. Just an Arctic jar. No, it's a lake trout. Might do a big loop this time. Bigger loop anyway. See if we can tempt another large-ish curry jar on before I have to go. Pretty well straight ahead. I wish you could put bite alarms on. Spinning rods when you're trawling. Somebody got a 9.3 kilo Arctic char. And Red Rock Panda got a 9 kilo Arctic salmon too. Thank you. getting a bit slow. Must have caught all the fish tonight. Guess we've got 84 in 2 hours and about 40 minutes. I guess, yeah, 2 hours, 45 minutes probably. So not quite my 100 in hour and 40 from Sunday. The Cupris, I wonder. Somebody said they got one. Weekly. C, D, F, G. I don't know what they're talking about. Not with a K anyway. You have much luck there with your wide-eyed brim, Belle. got a broken leader and rage quit. How'd you break your leader? Maybe a big eyed or something came along and broke you off, I guess. Those guys come and boom, hit you hard. Oh man, excuse me for that. Probably yeah, probably was like a big eye, I reckon. That'd be my guess. Those guys tend to just go boom. They don't mess around, from what I've encountered anyway. They just like, yeah, I can imagine. When I've been fishing for them though at Winding Rivulet, I've got them on much stronger leaders. I think I've had over 6 anyway kilo, and they've been happy enough to take my bait. Maybe you need to try one bigger. That said, you definitely know a lot more than I do, so. Oh, there you go. Just about when I am long enough. We might raid him. I'll probably be another, depending on how many fish we catch between here and the docks. We might be another 5 to 10 minutes. Then we'll raid him, I think. Perfect then, especially if we get something big. Yeah, I guess so. That makes sense. I try and for my Saturday and Sunday streams of this, try and start at 8:30 my time, which is 11 a.m. for you. Ooh, a grayling. I nearly never get grayling, and that's probably my biggest grayling, I reckon. Graylings seem very rare here, and they don't... they certainly don't seem to go for these spoons. Not quite as big as I was hoping, I think. This fish. Still big though, actually. Yeah. Big, yeah, 4 kilo lake trout's not too bad. Just not worth much silver. Oh, my boat only has an hour anyway. Minutes. Yeah, we might give up. So I don't need to buy another boat ticket. Can I make it? Of course I can. Perfect timing. Now, let's see if the cafe wants any of these fishies. Roach, no, they're all... we didn't catch a single perch that was big enough, and it needs 8 of them. Ah, well, let's see what the market's going to give me. 349 silver. Not terrible. Let's see by weight. So the big curry char's 45 silver. And the slightly smaller one's 35. But by price, the Savan trout's are the next best. The grayling's actually worth pretty good too. Very nice. Well, that was a good day's work. 92 fish for 349 silver, which obviously cannot have been a record. Interesting. Or maybe it doesn't keep a total one. I don't know. I think that'll do for me for today. Thank you very much for sticking around all this time, Belle Sherman. Thank you for all of your nice gifts. And your company has been very good. We might raid this guy if I can find him. Then you can see if you can win the competition or if that is a thing. Oh, he's got 64 people watching already. Just get him going. Start the raid. So, we'll see you tomorrow night if you want, or everybody else. See you next weekend, I guess. Otherwise, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Bye. Get this.